Good morning, dear students. Welcome to the science class. Today we continue our discussion on chapter 4, heat. In the previous classes, we learned about temperature is a measure of the degree of hotness of an object. A reliable measure of the hotness of an object is its temperature. Temperature is measured by a device called thermometer. We also learned about working of Klinecker thermometer, and the Klinecker thermometer is designed to measure the temperature of human body. And again we studied about laboratory thermometer. The last class we learned about transfer of heat, conduction, convection, radiation. In conduction, we know the process by which heat is transferred from the hotter end to the colder end of an object is known as conduction. And convection, the heat transfer in which heat is carried from the hotter part of the substance to its colder part by actual movement of hot particles in it is called convection. The heat transfer in which heat is carried from the hotter part of a substance to its colder part by actual movement of hot particles in it is called convection. Today, let us see what is sea breeze and land breeze. During daytime, the land gets heated faster than the water. The air over the land becomes hotter and rises up. The cooler air from the sea rushes in towards the land to take its place. The warmer air from the land moves towards the sea to complete the cycle. The air from the sea is called sea breeze. See, during daytime, the land gets heated faster than the water. So as a result, the air over the land becomes hotter and it rises up. So the cooler air from the sea rushes in towards the land to take its place. So the warm air from the land moves towards the sea in order to complete the cycle. So the air from the sea is called sea breeze. Here you can see. So to receive the cooler sea breeze, the windows of the houses in coastal areas are made to face the sea. During that time, the breeze blows from sea to land. You can see cool air from the sea to the land. You can see here also. So this is called a sea breeze. Next one is land breeze. At night time, it is exactly the reverse. The water cools down more slowly than the land. The air above water is warmer and rises, and the cool air from the land moves towards the sea to fill the space. So during night time, the water cools down more slowly than the land. So the air above water is warmer and rises, and the cool air from the land moves towards the sea to fill the space. This is called land breeze. So during night time, the breeze blows from land to sea. You can see here, from land to sea. So this is called land breeze. So during daytime, from sea to land. During night time, from land to sea. So next method of heat transfer is radiation. When we come out in the sun, we feel warm. How does the heat from the sun reach us? It cannot reach us by conduction or convection, as there is no medium such as air in most part of the space between the earth and the sun. And we know air is a poor conductor of heat. From the sun, the heat comes to us by another process known as radiation. So radiation is a process of heat transfer which does not require any material medium. Radiation is a process of heat transfer which does not require any material medium. The transfer of heat by radiation does not require any medium. It can take place whether a medium is present or not. When we sit in front of a room heater, we get heat by this process. A hot utensil kept away from the flame cools down as it transfers heat to the surroundings by radiation. Our body too gives heat to the surroundings and receives heat from it by radiation. So these are the examples. All hot bodies radiate heat, and when this heat falls on some object, a part of it is reflected, a part is absorbed, and a part may be transmitted. The temperature of the object increases due to the absorbed part of the heat. So all hot bodies radiate heat. When this heat falls on some object, a part of the heat is reflected, a part is absorbed, and part may be transmitted, and the temperature of the object increases due to the absorbed part of the heat. So let us see the kinds of clothes we wear in summer and winter. So you know that in summer season we prefer light colored clothes, and in winter season we usually wear dark colored clothes. Why is it so? So let us go for an activity. Take two identical tin cans, paint the outer surface of one black and the other one white. Here you can see two cans. One is painted black, another one is painted white. Pour equal amounts of water in each and leave them in the midday sun for about an hour. Measure the temperature of water in both the cans. Do you find any difference in the temperatures? In which cans is the water warmer? You can feel the difference even by touching water in the two cans. You know, water is warmer in black can. Again, another activity, fill two cans with the same amount of hot water at the same temperature, say around 60 degrees Celsius. Leave the cans in a room or in a shade. Note the temperature of water after 10 to 15 minutes. Does the temperature of water in both the cans fall by the same amount? So water in the white can is cooler than water in the black can. So do these activities suggest to you the reason why is it more comfortable to wear white or light colored clothes in the summer and dark colored clothes in the winter? So this is a reason. Dark surface absorb more heat, and therefore we feel comfortable with the dark colored clothes in the winter season. Dark surface absorb more heat, and therefore we feel comfortable with the dark colored clothes in the winter season. Light colored clothes reflect most of the heat and falls on them, and therefore we feel more comfortable wearing them in the summer season. Light colored clothes reflect most of the heat that falls on them, and therefore we feel more comfortable wearing them in the summer season. So woolen clothes keep us warm in winter. How? In the winter season, we use woolen clothes. Wool is a poor conductor of heat, and moreover, there is air trapped in between the wool fibers. This air prevents the flow of heat from our body to the cold surroundings. So we feel warm. So wool is a poor conductor of heat, and there is air trapped in between the wool fibers. And the air prevents the flow of heat from our body to the cold surrounding. So we feel warm. Dear students, this is all for today's class. Today we completed Chapter 4. In the next class, we'll discuss the questions and answers. Till then, bye.